So what's an ordinal? Is it a bird? Is it a compass direction? Is it a statistic? Well, it's all of those things, but in this video, we're going to tap into the Bitcoin ecosystem and see how Bitcoin ordinals are the next evolution of NFTs on the Bitcoin blockchain. We're not gonna get into the down and dirty nitty gritty technical aspects of inscribing a rare Pepe on the Bitcoin blockchain, but we do have a live cam of a developer doing their best to spice up the Bitcoin network a bit. With the technical stuff out of the way, stick around for another 3 minutes and we'll show you how and where you can buy an ordinal. Now, to wrap your head around NFTs on Bitcoin, you have to first understand what a Satoshi is. And for that, we're gonna bring in Doc Segwit to explain. Doc, take it away.
Thanks, Chris. Bitcoin would not be Bitcoin without a Satoshi, literally and figuratively. Each Bitcoin called a Satoshi, named after the creator of the Bitcoin white paper. Similar to how a dollar bill can be broken down into 100 pennies.
Okay, armed with that knowledge, each ordinal is inscribed into a single Satoshi on the Bitcoin network. That's actually a bit of a misnomer because each Satoshi already has an ordinal that describes its place in the blockchain. This means that each ordinal has a date and a unique identifier. And the data, whether it be an image, a message, or just gibberish, can be inscribed into the data area of the Satoshi. An inscription differs from an NFT because it lacks a smart contract that mints a unique token, separate from any other part of a blockchain. With an ordinal inscription, the NFT lives with a Satoshi.
Oh, like peanut butter and jelly.
Well, that's kind of a weird analogy, but okay, they do taste great together. It took me a minute to understand this difference because on a smart contract platform like Ethereum or Solana, the token has its own address on the blockchain. And if you want to send that token, you just put in an address and make the transfer. With an inscription, you could accidentally send your ordinal out of your wallet when making a transaction. If this is the case, the miner who validates the block the inscription is included in will now own that inscription. And as we know, Bitcoin transactions are not reversible. So be careful, you could accidentally lose your inscription. If you've been around for a while, you may be aware of some of the past controversies by Bitcoin developers regarding technical upgrades to the network. And we're not here today to debate on the merits of any part of the Bitcoin protocol. However, it's precisely those improvements that have led to the ability to inscribe data into the network. Now, some of the current controversies over Bitcoin inscriptions are about copyright and the use of extra space in each block for something meaningful, rather than what some developers consider clutter. However, with over 65 million inscriptions on the blockchain, it looks like inscriptions are here to stay. And fortunately, you don't need to be a developer to take part.
All right, FOMO's hit. Where can I buy an ordinal?
Now, in the past, not many wallets supported or recognized ordinals, but today it's as easy as going to Magic Eden, selecting the Bitcoin network, and connecting your Magic Eden wallet. Find the ordinal that you want to buy. Now remember, this is a secondary market and the ordinal you're buying has already been inscribed to a Satoshi. You can click on the details and see the inscription number. Set your fee, and that's it. You now have an inscription forever attached to the Bitcoin network. We hope you found this video helpful, so please give a like and subscribe for more great crypto videos from Exodus.